Located along the Douro River estuary in northern Portugal, Porto is one of the oldest European cities, its center designated as a World Heritage Site. But this summer, it's all about another world. The World University Championships in beach volleyball. 58 teams taking part altogether, 32 men's, 26 women's from 26 countries. Over the years, we've built extraordinary skills to be able to stage this tournament. We have the support of the university, the sporting university programs, and the support of the government. Portugal is a perfect place for this FISU university competition. Playing against Solvoll and Lunde of Norway, the Americans winning by 2-1. So it was the USA against Germany for the beach volleyball title. And the USA coming out the winners, 2-0. In the men's semi-finals, some terrific play, and really all four teams deserve to be in the final. However, there's only room for two, and Holler and Schroeder of Germany took the win over Brazil's first team by 2-0. Poland won, beating the Austrians, Dressler and Kuna, 2-1. The Austrians would beat the Brazilians to take the bronze medal. For the final, expectations were high and the teams didn't let anyone down. With a full stadium, the spectators were treated to a cracking game. In the end, Germany would beat the Polish duo by 2-0. And then, as the teams were presented with their medals, gold for USA and Germany, the FISU flag would be passed from the Portuguese to the Estonian delegation, the organizing country of the next World University Championships in beach volleyball in 2016. This is Campus Sport, and in part three, we'll travel to Lenica in Poland for the Archery World Championships. And then to Hungary and Pécs for a little bit of wrestling.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders. When education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.